ideal and a reality. This is not how it goes in real life, right? 3 to 4 points. Good news. Throw out all the unnecessary details. Job done. What do we want to achieve with any pitch or presentation? Well, here's what we hope for. We present and the audience listen, understand, and remember. And we throw in as many details as possible to achieve that. Well, I've discovered that there is an ideal and a reality about these three things. Ideally, we want them to listen 100%, understand 100%, and remember 100%. But this is not how it goes in real life, right? So what is realistic? Well, my research has shown a very different outcome. Even with very good presentations, the audience will only listen a maximum of 70 to 80%. Hey, they're human beings too. They have a lot going on in their lives. They're easily distracted. So 70 to 80% is the max that you can expect. Then we come to understanding. And even with clear, concise pitches, again, 70 to 80% is the most they will understand. People need a bit of time to process stuff. So let's get real on this. They understand around 70% of the 70% they listen to. Do the math and you come to less than half. And what does that mean they will remember? Well, shockingly, it's no more than 3 to 4 points. You might ask yourself, why would I bother? Well, all is not lost. You see, it's not all about the brain, what they understand and remember. There's the part about what they feel. They make judgments about you and your business on an emotional level. Can I trust this person? If I buy from this company, am I in good hands? Are they professional? If I ask them a question, will they get a straight answer or will it take forever? You communicate this with how professionally you prepare yourself and the way that you deliver the story. Having a great opening, making the first word count, not overtelling, keeping focused on the good stuff, being clear on the next steps in your closing, sharing your personal enthusiasm, making the pitch human, and ensuring they go away with the three big messages you want them to focus on afterwards. This means good news. You can reduce your pitch and throw out all the unnecessary details. But don't worry about cutting, because you might think, if I get rid of this piece of detail, they won't understand. Well, they won't understand anyway. So narrow the story down so that they can get that feeling and the essentials. Now, this is really different to the usual way of presentation. Open PowerPoint, jam the content into the slides, showing as much as possible and hope some of it will stick. So let's ask ourselves again, what do we want to achieve with any pitch or presentation? I believe the answer is get them to walk away with a great feeling about you as a professional and your company proposition. And get them to engage with you to find out more face to face, online, or anywhere they can access the details to back up the messages you've shared with them. Reduce the detail, keep it focused, and be human. This will help your pitch connect with your audience and they'll love following up with you. Job done.